one then.
How you gonna do this, son? Yes, I have 16 bars, man, no punchings.
One then.
Most of y'all ain't ready for this. I'm gonna be talking about some things I hear that many people won't appreciate, alright?
I was raised in streets so cold where hopes rose, where little kids walk around with no clothes. And not because they have no homes, but this is how they were shown, how to live too fast and act too grown. Where most live so high yet only know lows, never learn how to stand on their own, cause you always face life on their toes. When this concrete jungle with all of its woes, there are roses in Harlem that somehow still grow. And I suppose with more tilling their flowers will show, nurture the children and the wind will blow, and the world would be a better place instead of the cheddar race. Or if not a threat to humanity we will forever face, cause round my block the youth are used as modern day pawns, hustling death till there's nothing left from dusk to dawn. To every last bit of their soul is gone, and they forever travel in shadows to live life amongst the scorn, wishing they could be reborn, looking for a jack to feed on, and some of them mentally be gone. And since they never got their read on, they never understood why I was born for them to see their seed born. So the next generation grieves on and bleeds on, and this could happen for eons, unless we form a legion to attack these demons that wanna stop our breathing, so we can't inhale freedom. How many of our kids have asthma due to the plaster? How many of our family members suffer from cancer? Still look at this government for answers. How many of our youth go bananas at the color bandanas, cause their minds have been desensitized by the time they finish failing grandma? Live most of their lives failing grandma in the slammer, trying to make runs from the slums of New York to Atlanta. Didn't know the difference between a Black Panther and a white panda. Both were extinct animals if you asked them, but if you couldn't mask them and examine and show them all the horror in their lives, they observed the curve random was due to years of steady planning. Our people have been left stranded and abandoned, trapped in way before Katrina ever happened. This might create a passion that might move them into action, to take their freedom of their people without asking, without vote casting, cause that hasn't ever had an effect on those who haven't. The have-nots who never had it, never could get it. Raised to be addicts, I wish the whole hood would shed it. Crackers embedded so far in our neighborhoods, community boards are segmented. Most people we thought represented us were demented, looking at 401k pensions instead of where these land grabbers were headed. Let's get a bit prevented, buildings which are rented. Now you need a mortgage for the poor kids, the playgrounds are now fenced. So you can see how the young tots damaged from a life of untold knocks, run away from homes with no pops and hand-me-down jeans or old socks, away from their mom that pops. It can clearly see the traction of arms will only lead to a cold box, and this is why they run non-stop, especially from cold cops. And blocks that have been co-op, but there's no ops since Pell was cropped. Went into a ciphers of no-knots at road pot and whole blocks, but the dough got them at 30 below, pushing snow like they robots. To be sent upstate and smothered where the post lock, and this is to the youth that everyone forgot. But my purpose is to convince you, the lyrical use at its pinnacle, will show you how the system can make you utterly cynical. How you tired from a mental umbilical, why you're skeptical about your freedom even being perceptible. Why breaking free is questionable, but freedom is so visible beyond their economic principles. As emancipation can't be divisible by 10, so won't be related to anything you spend, nothing you can lend, no affiliation to the dollar, euro, yen. Freedom will look like no gem, couldn't tell you all by the number of inches on your rims, no matter how many pairs of tins or what you wear in your limbs. This is not where freedom begins, but this is exactly where it ends. Cause when I speak of liberation, I'm talking beyond America's upper class imagination, beyond taking long vacations, beyond a house with land the size of the South's largest slave plantation, beyond any payment. Freedom is not some external sensation, it's definitely a test of patience. Some say patience is a virtue, others say it may curse you, but I know hesitant cats in your circle would definitely hurt you. Others may think progress must mirror the moves of a turtle, but I'm sure it's a race ran at its own pace with many a hurdle. And for our movement, the ground's fertile, so I urge you to purge through. The cops already set a curfew, if they catch you after hours, they definitely search you, might even murder you. Now I'm rhyming for the fuck it, but I take this personal. This is reality rap, not in virtue. Back to hell, this can nurse you, give it a Holy Spirit like church you. For those locked in a metaphorical box, this will help you burst through. Cause the project blues, we're just scratching the surface. Now our purpose go to depths like the dollar, show you America's worthless. No matter what you purchase, this downfall is not temporary but permanent. As economists searches for words that won't make investors nervous, Wall Street can't avoid the closing curtains. I'm 100% certain a $1 trillion war is a huge cause for the hurting. Increased rates for Kabul will add to the burden, and 700 military bases for future Vietnam to have lurking. You better off going online, linking to pound conversion, or run down to the bank urging to buy bonds backed by the Chinese yuan in person. But no matter how many corporate bailouts or stimulus packages, there'll be perpetual crashes, inevitable clashes between the classes. Years of self-serving for supplies I'm earning, got them printing the mirrors as fast as they can, cause the dollar's burning.
equipment and constructing a super corridor to fortify the North American Union. From Mexico to Canada for international cargo moving. They're fucking shifting humans as gentrification is a part of a bigger plan of population redistribution, creating super cities trapped by super highways. And you need a passport to even travel sideways. And if you have questions and have places of preventive detention, here there's a misinformation obsession. They're in a depression, they can barely say recession. They're playing 1984, them all with their aggression. Orwell, the Orwells with their advanced weapons. Now who has pity on a Sunni in Sardar City? See me as a young studious religious boy praying, hoping God is with me. As reality starts to hit me, these American bullets start to rip me. I survived, my sister didn't, so now I'm jihad strictly. Already forgiven, ready to give up living. Deadly with no precision, blasting at the walls of my hopes in prison. With the hatred of the American fleet that runs really deep, I'ma have a bomb strapped to my chest, but I don't value my life really cheap. This hill I climb is really steep, and only with this IED will the world hear me speak.